MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game two of the ALDS between the Tampa Bay Rays and the New York Yankees. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, an important ballgame coming up here in game two.
Yeah, this is just a five-game series, so getting that first win under you is great. The most important game of a series, though, is the next one you're about to play. So treating this game like it's absolutely critical is a good way not to get too comfortable with your lead.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen. And we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Corey Kluber will be on the bump for game two of the series. What's your take, Dan?
On comes former Cy Young Award winner Corey Kluber. Might have the best right-handed breaking ball in baseball. Great velocity, too, 94 to 96. And he'll throw that comebacker that he'll start at a left-hander's hip and bring it back over home plate. Big overhand breaking curveball. Not a true curveball, more of a slurve, but it's nasty. Does have a changeup. If he has all three of his pitches, he's nearly impossible to center.
Kluber will take it himself for the first out of the inning.
The second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Up next for the Rays, Brandon Lau. Fastball's too much for him there, one and two. Kluber has racked up over 1,300 innings on the Major League mound, and with an ERA just hovering around the 3.00 benchmark. The 1-2.
Ball.
Perfect baseball weather, 82 degrees at first pitch tonight. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. And there's out number two. Base is empty, two away. And up next will be Randy Arozarena.
That's a ball.
He's falling behind now, 3-1.
This is a good at-bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Frazier will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Down in order go the Rays. Say nothing. Yankees coming up. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Hill is on the mound for game two. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 3-2 pitch. He's in there, a called strike three.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
To the box now, Aaron Judge. Hit sharply on the ground. Throw on to first, two gone.
That is good. The center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Aye. Two strikes.
classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
The 2-2.
It's a called strike three on the corner.
1-2-3 go the Bombers. And this is still a nothing-nothing ball game.
New inning set to get underway, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. And two now as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. Look out. That pitch sends him tumbling to the ground. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
That is good.
Next, here is Manuel Margot. The 1-2. This one's down to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw gets him. Two down.
That is good. The third base.
And so with two away now, let's give you another look at our playoff bracket as you see what could lie ahead for the winner in this series. Joey Wendell digs in now. Ready with the 1-1. Soft liner to the right side, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the veteran DH, Giancarlo Stanton. And the pitch. And this ball runs away from ball two, 2-1. Into the windup and the pitch. There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. Back goes Kiermaier. And it's gone. A solo home run. The bat of Giancarlo Stanton. His second home run of the series as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Stepping in now, Luke Voit. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. Him off the hook there as this isn't even close for ball four.
And I'm sure the manager is fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up or he can really hurt you.
At the plate now is Gleyber Torres. From the stretch. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Oh.
fastball.
And a good eye as he lays off, and the count moves to 2-1 now on the Yankee left fielder. Down the left field line and deep, and it's a foul ball. Boyd, base runner at first with one out. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location. So a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. Toward third. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Yankees are off and running early thanks to the solo home run. We've played two. It's now 1-0 New York. Leading off the inning, it'll be Willy Adames, and they could use a spark from him here. Popped him up. LeMahieu stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone. So one down, no one aboard. And that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. Now here it comes. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And he's not stopping. He wants three. The relay. But he is in there with a triple. The speed they always talk about with this guy was on full display there.
Yeah, when you've got elite speed like this guy does, man, you don't need any help from the fielders to give you more time. He's thinking extra bases as soon as the ball gets to the outfield. And that time, he wanted three.
Cenino, and he got him.
That strikeout changes the whole complexion of the inning. He was definitely pitching for it with a run on third and one out, and he got it. Now it's going to take a hit or something like a wild pitch to get that guy home.
So now to the plate, Austin Meadows. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side.
I love everything this pitcher got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
And the curveball bounces here, but a good job behind the plate to keep it at arm's length. Two outs here with a runner at third. Full count, three balls and two to the Rays DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Payoff pitch on its way, and it's fouled away. He's set the 3-2. Hit down the third baseline. He's got it. Throw on to Wolf, takes care of him, and the inning is over. One left for Tampa. They're down 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. Now the 2-1. Strike two, swinging.
Two and two.
Got him.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at-bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
And now, DJ LeMahieu hit the other way out toward right field. Margo is there, two down.
The right fielder, another nugget.
Up next, Aaron Judge. He bounced out last time up. A 1-1. There's a slider that can't catch the outside.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Two out, nobody on. And they set up away with the fastball, but it misses. 3-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
The 3-1. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Now batting, center fielder, Aaron.
Two down with a runner at first. That'll bring up the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. The 1-2.
Two ball, two strikes.
Now a curveball misses inside.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Judge leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Got him swinging, and that's the third out. One left for the Yankees, but they're up 1-0. Things out here against Corey Kluber. Here comes the 1-2. Pops him up toward the left side of the infield, and there's out number one. So bases are empty with one gone, and up next will be Randy Arozarena. In the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Judge, and he makes the catch in the corner. So next to bat will be G-Man Choi. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. 1-1.
Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
The plate now, Manuel Margo. Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. We'll try again, 1-2. A swing and a miss at a sinker. The strikeout retires the side. Inning is over. Rays strand just the one. They're short end of
score. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up. And he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this goes on.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And digging in is the big-time power threat, Giancarlo Stanton.
Boy, this guy right here, that last AB, how about straightaway center field? He hits a bomb, and as a pitcher, you're trying to pick a big part of the ballpark, but a guy like this, if he has pop to hit it out to center field, I might have to think pitching this guy down and away down on the corner.
Now batting, first baseman.
At the plate, Luke Voit. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees' first baseman. Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. Working for the punch out and the offering. Now this is slowly hit to short, probably too slowly to get to. And indeed he won't look at second. He'll just flip it on over to first to take the sure out. Man at second with one down, and that will bring up Gleyber Torres. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch drilled to the left side. And that's through into left of base. Now a long throw home. But this won't be in time as he's well safe and the run scores.
Now back, left field. Great.
Standing in now, Clint Frazier.
That's ball.
Inside and low, 2-1.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
Here's the 2-1. Left center, base hit. And this one bounds around against the wall. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double. Time will be called here as you see the pitching coach making his way after the mound to pay a quick visit. Into the box now, Gio Urshela. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
And he misses with it. Ball four. Load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
And you can tell by his body language that he's beyond frustrated by that call. He's got to be wondering what he's got to do, but the last thing he needs to do is to let it get under his skin. That will only make things worse.
Bases are loaded here with one away. And that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Torres on third. Frazier over at second. Urshela is over at first with one away. Not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
You fight so hard to get into these type of counts, you can't let this pitch get away from you. You have to keyhole something middle of the plate.
And, oh, that should have been ball four there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2. And he fouls this one off.
hear that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. Another one sent foul. Two runs, four hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Grounded to third. This could be two. Reined in. The tag gets one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Yankees forced to settle for one. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And that'll give way to the third baseman, Joey Wendell. The 1-1 home. Is a bunt attempt, but he missed it.
Hey, I know we're not scoring, but in today's day and age, trying to bunt for a hit, he's going to find himself on the bench tomorrow.
Swung on, but fouled off to the left. Here he comes again, 1-2. Swing and a flare down the line, and that'll get down for a base hit. Now, Willy Adames, breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. So a full count now. Kevin Kiermaier, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. No runs, 3 hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. And misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. He found his way over to third via a triple in his first at bat. Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
2-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Hit in the air to straightaway center. After it is Hicks. Gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And he'll get into third here on the flyout, so he's 90 feet away here with one gone.
Good read there at second base to know he can make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
So now here is Mike Zunino, and they're runners at the corners now. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
Into the box, Austin Meadows. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now. Runners on first and third, two away. One-two is a breaking ball. He can't find the zone, and it's even at two. Line hard toward right center. Judge is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Rays strand a pair. They trail it here 2-0. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
What a great battle to start this inning. What a great job by the leadoff hitter. He knows that this pitcher's starting to get up there in pitches. The manager's starting to get restless. Let's see if we can knock him out and get into that bullpen.
Swing and a little blooper to center. Kiermaier coming on, but he can't get there. That's down for a base hit. With that, the Yankees have put their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning.
The right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Stepping in now, Aaron Judge. Bounce. He'll go to the bag for one. On to first, and they get the double play.
Now that is the center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
Now at the plate, here is Aaron Hicks. No one on base for him after the double play.
Yeah, Matt, that two ball really changed the complexion of this inning. It looked like the middle of the order was going to have a chance to get a big hit with some ducks on the pond, but now they just have to try and get a two-out rally started.
Trying to strike him out for the third time. Seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Yanks held in check as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Now at the plate, Brandon Lau. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ball game.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
Pitch on 2-1. Just low that time with the heavy sinker as it's ruled ball three.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
Fouled off. Here comes the payoff pitch. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
He's been in total control out there tonight. Gets the leadoff guy with a strike out there, and it just seems like we've seen so many off-balance swings and weakly hit balls in this one.
And now, Randy Arozarena. Looks like he swung it underwater that time for strike two.
Well, you know you've got it working on the mound when they're swinging right through it, even when you're putting it right down the middle of the strike zone. Not the greatest of game plans, though.
2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
And this guy's a double threat up there. He can run, and he can go yard, too. You don't want to walk him because he might steal a base on you, but you don't want to groove a fastball either because he can take you out of the yard.
Down the third baseline. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the first baseman, D-Man.
To the plate now, G-Man Choi. Two balls and a strike to the Rays' first baseman. Sinker 2-2 now.
You rarely see a pitcher of this quality throw one right down the middle, and man, as a hitter, probably a good chance you're not going to see that pitch again.
Now a move over to first, and the runner back easily. A Rosarena, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Fouled away. Trying to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Now the payoff pitch home. Locks him up for strike three.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
At the plate, Manuel Margot. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ballgame, and that ends the inning. One left for Tampa. They're down 2-0. Colin McHugh enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for the Rays, number 31, Colin McHugh.
Striding forward now is the DH, Giancarlo Stanton. He's off to a fast start in this one, 2-for-2, including a home run. McHugh gets the sign, coming home with the 1-1 pitch. Ground ball left side. Adames picks it up. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Next for New York, Boyd. It out in his last at bat. So 1-1 home. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Standing in now, Gleyber Torres. That one yanked just foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. And this will miss down low in the third, so he's working full now at 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
High in the air out to center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it, and the inning is over. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, but they're on top 2-0. All set for the start of the inning, and set to go is the third baseman, Joey Wendell. Now here it comes. Lays off 2-2 now. Double barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him. One out now in the Tampa Bay 7th. And up next will be Willie Adames. Bases are empty. One man out. And he drops a changeup right down Broadway for a called strike.
might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
And that's the second out. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Kevin Kiermaier. Hit him two tries for him so far. Now the 3-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Taking it in there is Hicks for the final out of the inning. Down in order go the Rays. They trail things here 2-0. Chaz Rome will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 50, Chaz.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Clint Frazier. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. The 2-2.
We got a full.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Payoff pitch home. Chopper down the third baseline. But that finds its way through for a base hit. He'll get it into second. Not in time. And he's with a double.
Good one pitcher is absolutely dealing right now. So this is a big moment in this game. If his teammates can pick him up and drive him in now, that might be all they need to get the W here.
Now, Giorgella. Oh, forget about this one. Ba-ba-booey. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. So a two-run homer down the line and left. As the Yankees start to pull away a bit, it's now 4-0.
Wasn't the plan. You just have a meeting with your pitching coach to go over some strategy, and all of a sudden you throw one and it leaves the ballpark.
Into the box, Gary Sanchez. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Lifetime versus this pitcher. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Base is empty here with nobody out. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first down.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a two-run shot, but that at bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it get to him. He went right after him for the strikeout.
Into the box now, DJ LeMahieu. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that'll get down out there near the wall. The relay, but he'll be in there with a double.
That's what happens when it doesn't do what you want it to do. That was just one of those cement mixers, kind of just spinning but doing nothing. Nice job of punishing that pitch and picking up two bags on one swing.
Diego Castillo takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs, seventh frame. to the plate now, Aaron Judge.
Ball inside.
Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off 3-1.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot.
There's a swing and a drive, and everybody's just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no-doubt home run. All rise, Aaron Judge. A two-run shot as they pile on. It's now 6-0. Just a majestic home run to watch, and I certainly think it's worth looking at with our show track technology. You don't see many home runs in that territory, and with a projected distance coming in at 470 feet, it backs it up. A really impressive blast. Stepping in now, Aaron Hicks. 1-2 now. Good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Lifted the other way to left center. Left fielder is on the move. He makes the running play. Two down. Now digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. There's the 2-1 home. Good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
Ew, is that ugly? You could probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the rosin bag if you throw it up there.
And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. So 4 runs in the inning, and they come on the strength of the 2 big flies. 8th inning coming up. It's the Yankees 6, the Rays nothing. So here's Mike Zunino. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Hit sharply on the ground. Beautiful diving stop. It's there. He got him.
Boy, I'll tell you, the defense has been stellar all night long. They've got the shutout working, and there's another super play to rob them of a hit.
In now, Austin Meadows. And good take that time on a low breaking ball, too.
Well, he's throwing a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. Throw on the first will get him. Scored at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are 2 away now. 2 out, nobody on. And this is taken here for ball 4. Just the 2nd walk he's allowed into his 8th inning of work.
Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
Here comes the Yankee skipper on his way to the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So this home crowd likely to give him a standing O as he departs with the shutout in check and a nice tip of the cap there to acknowledge a job well done. Luis Sessa enters the ball game out of the pen looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8.
Number 85, Luis Sessa.
A Randy Arozarena will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Grounder down the line at third. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Rays strand just the one. They stand themselves down 6-0. Now in the box, Luke Voit. In his career versus this pitcher, he's hitless in 6 tries. They have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Manny V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-World, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did that as well.
3-2 pitch. Hit down the line at first. The next 3-2. Left side of the infield into the shift. Adames brings it in, and there are two away now. Next to hit, Clint Frazier. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Got to believe the pitcher and catcher understand the fact that he's covering away, and he's covering way away. Don't be shocked.
We'll have to press pause as that strike 3 to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They lead it 6-0. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, G-Man Choi. He's the one to start off the ninth inning with his guys in danger of going down 2-0 if they can't rally. Now the 2-1. Hit softly down the line at first. He's right there, and he'll step on first himself for the out. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot, who sat down on strikes in his last at bat. Now the 2-1. One out, nobody on. In the air, down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. LeMahieu. Tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. Crowd in excess of 37,000 come to their feet. And that misses 2-2.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Tampa down to their final strike in this one. Still 2-2. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. And he'll check his swing here. Did he go around? Yes, and the ball game is over.
Well, this game had its moments, but it got out of hand pretty quick. Always nice when you could post to a 6-run win.
Save your closer for another day and let everyone in on the action.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. A 6-0 shutout to finish off tonight's game. New York get the win to take a 2-0 series lead. Corey Kluber takes home the win. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 6 runs, 9 hits, no errors, they left 5 men on base. For the Rays, no runs, 4 hits, no errors, they left 6 men on base. The winning pitcher is Corey Kluber. The loss goes to Rich Hill. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 54 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.